Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for September 5th. Today is the Thursday of the 22nd week in Ordinary Time. Let's have that moment of silence to prepare us for our prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Stir up your mighty power, Lord, come to our aid.
O Shepherd of Israel, hear us. You who lead Joseph's flock, shine forth from your cherubim throne upon Ephraim, Benjamin, Manasseh. O Lord, rouse up your might. O Lord, come to our help.
God of hosts, bring us back. Let your face shine on us, and we shall be saved.
Lord God of hosts, how long will you frown on your people's plea? You have fed them with tears for their bread, and abundance of tears for their drink. You have made us the tongue of our neighbors. Our enemies laugh us to scorn.
God of hosts, bring us back. Let your face shine on us, and we shall be saved.
You brought a vine out of Egypt to plant if you drove out the nations. Before if you cleared the ground, it took root and spread through the land.
The mountains were covered with its shadow, the cedars of God with its boughs. It stretched out its branches to the sea, to the great river it stretched out its shoots.
Then why have you broken down its walls? It is black by all who pass by. It is ravaged by the war of the forest, devoured by the beasts of the field.
God of hosts, turn again, we implore. Look down from heaven and see. Visit this vine and protect it, the vine your right hand has planted. Men have burned it with fire and destroyed it. May they perish at the frown of your face.
May your hand be on the man you have chosen, the man you have given your strength, and we shall never forsake you again. Give us life that we may call upon your name.
God of hosts, bring us back. Let your face shine on us, and we shall be saved.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Stir up your mighty power, Lord. Come to our aid.
The Lord has worked marvels for us. Make it known to the ends of the world.
I give you thanks, O Lord, though you have been angry with me. Your anger has abated, and you have consoled me.
God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and He has been my Savior.
With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation and say on that day, Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim His name among the nations, make known His deeds, proclaim how exalted is His name.
Sing praise to the Lord for His glorious achievement. Let this be known through all the earth.
Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great is your midst, is the Holy One of Israel.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord has worked marvels for us. Make it known to the ends of the world.
Ring out your joy to God, our strength.
Ring out your joy to God, our strength. Shout in triumph to the gods of Jacob.
Raise a song and sound the timbrel, the sweet sounding harp and the lute. Blow the trumpet at the new moon, when the moon is full and our feast.
For this is Israel's law, a command of the God of Jacob. He imposed it as a rule of Joseph when he went out against the land of Egypt.
A voice I did not know said to me, I free your shoulder from the burden. Your hands were free from the load. You called in distress and I save you.
I answered, concealed in the storm cloud. At the waters of Meribah I tested you. Listen, my people, to my warning. O Israel, if only you would heed.
Let there be no foreign God among you, no worship of alien God. I am the Lord your God, who brought you from the land of Egypt. Open wide your mouth, and I will fill it.
But my people did not heed my voice, and Israel would not obey. So I left them in the stubbornness of heart to follow their own delights.
Oh, that my people would heed me, that Israel would walk in my ways. At once I would subdue their foes, turn my hands against their enemies.
The Lord's enemies would cringe at their feet, and their subjection would last forever. But Israel I would feed with finest wheat, and fill them with honey from the rack.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Ring out your joy to God, our strength.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The kingdom of God is not a matter of eating or drinking, but of justice, peace, and the joy that is given by the Holy Spirit. Whoever serves Christ in this way pleases God and wins the esteem of men. Let us then make it our aim to work for peace and to strengthen one another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. In today's reading, the Apostle Paul tells the Romans, and he tells us, that the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating or drinking. In other words, the things of this world are not important. What's important is fighting for justice, peace, building each other up in our communities. Today, Paul is challenging us to put aside the things of the world, not to worry so much about the worries of what am I going to eat, or where am I going to go, or what am I going to do in this life, but to think about the things of eternity, which for now is building up the kingdom of God, building each other up, and fighting for peace and justice. These are the things that are important, to look for the lowly and help them out. There's so many people that are on the streets looking for help, for a handout. In today's gospel, Jesus calls Peter. And Peter, after telling Jesus that, you know, he's already fished all day, and Jesus says to put his net off to one side, and Peter, being the fisherman, doesn't think there's any chance of catching fish. And when the nets are filled with fish, he feels ashamed that he didn't trust in Jesus. But Jesus tells him, be not afraid, don't be afraid. You'll be fishing for more than fish. You'll be fishers of men. And so today, we too are reminded that we shouldn't be afraid to give ourselves completely to the Lord, to have trust in Him, to know that He will take care of everything. We are called today to build each other up and to have trust in God, to know that as long as we put our faith in Him, everything will be just fine. He'll put us exactly where we need to be, and He will take care of all the things that need to be taken care of. God is so powerful. He's so awesome. God is so good and merciful. He wants us to be a part of His kingdom. He wants us to build each other up. He wants us to work as a community, to embrace that challenge by trusting in Him. So as we go on through this prayer service, reflect on how you can build each other up in different ministries. Tear down those walls that separate us, maybe language or customs, and reach out to each other and build each other up. God bless you, and have a wonderful day.
In the early hours of the morning, I think of you, O Lord.
In the early hours of the morning, I think of you, O Lord.
Always you are there to help me.
I think of you, O Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
In the early hours of the morning, I think of you, O Lord.
Give your people knowledge of salvation, Lord, and forgive us our sins.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to His people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of His servant David.
Through His holy prophets, He promised of old that He would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember His holy covenant.
This was His oath He swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship Him without fear, holy and righteous in His sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare His way, to give His people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Give your people knowledge of salvation, Lord, and forgive us our sins. Blessed be God our Father, who protects his children and never spurns their prayers. Let us humbly implore him. Enlighten us, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for enlightening us through your Son.
Fill us with his light throughout the day.
Let your wisdom lead us today, Lord,
that we may walk in the newness of life.
May we bear hardship with courage for your name's sake.
And be generous in serving you.
Direct our thoughts, feeling, and action this day.
Help us to follow your providential guidance.
Let us pause for a moment to lift up our prayers and petitions to our loving God and Father. Heavenly Father, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Father, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we pray. Enlighten us, Lord.
Gathering our prayers and praises into one, we now pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, true light and source of all light, listen to our morning prayer. Turn our thoughts to what is holy, and may we ever live in the light of your love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time,
same place,
same channel. Have a great day.